Hi, come in. Good morning.
Morning.
Okay, do for you.
Captain.
Please sit down. How's things?
Great, we're doing fine right now. Swank, thanks so much for fitting in this interview with us despite your busy schedule.
Oh, it's my pleasure. You're most welcome.
Okay, so let's jump right in.
Can you describe yourself in 3 words?
Okay, myself? Well, I'm energetic. I'm thoughtful. Last but not least, I'm holistic.
Oh, definitely I agree with those.
What have you been up to lately?
Oh, it's during the recess now. Work-wise, we've been pretty busy, you know. I've got deadlines to keep as in finishing up the exam. After work, of course, every day is like leaving office at about 6 to 7, and by the time I reach home, I'll try to go for my jog as usual, but if I can't do that, then I'll settle down with the family and relax in front of the TV. Yeah?
It's good to have work-life balance, right? How long have you actually been teaching?
Oh, I've been at NTU since 2016. It's coming to a good 4 years or so, 4 years plus.
Wow, oh, time really flies. So, a curious question, what is actually that badge there?
This one?
Yeah.
Oh, this is one of the very important things in my life, and that's my religion. It's a Japanese religion, faith called Mahikari. Basically, I have this every day on my shirt. It's basically to keep me going and to keep me strong every day. And most importantly is, to glorify God's name.
Wow, okay. So, what do you think is the best food in school?
Wow, this is a challenging question. Well, I think, although I know most of us, the students say we eat to live in NTU, but I think the food which I enjoyed most will be the char kway teow from Box in Canteen A.
Yeah, it's really good food there. So we actually followed you on IG, so can you tell us a little bit more about the backstory of this picture?
Uh-huh. What is this? I see. Okay. Yes. My Dalcona coffee challenge. Yeah? Well, during the closed circuit breaker, when we are locked down at home, this is my favorite, which we have been spending. So what did I do? I enjoyed my Dalcona coffee almost every evening, in the morning and in the evening. That's my favorite pastime.
So you have a sweet tooth, I presume?
Yeah, I guess so.
I see that you have some potted plants over there.
These ones? Yeah. These is my favorite in my office. Basically, as I preach very much into environment. We've been talking about environmental friendly. We're talking about green shipping. So this is all green. And this is the plants which I take care of every day here. And these plants have been growing since day one. They were so small. And this is a good, 4 years?
You must have green fingers to be
able
to.
Yeah, you have this tomato. You have this tomato plant. We have got the mint, and we have got some kind of vegetable, I think.
Huh?
And we have got the 2 types of mint: the small one and the big ones.
Nice. Which one is your favorite?
Oh, my favorite is the small little mint here, right? This is the mint. This is the one which typical, you do your laksa and all that, and it's very mintish. Yeah.
Wow. Okay. I see you have a ship model over there, and.
This one? Yeah, we have got, the sailing ship was given to me when I was going to talk to one of those Indonesian academics that came into NTU. Well, this one is a typical bulk carrier, this model was presented to me when I was delivering a ship, as you can see over there. You see the group photo there? Yeah, that was in China, where I was with the team.
Right there.
And yeah, at the end, you can see that photo. That is the time I delivered the ship, and this was given to me as a memento.
Really curious, how long have you been sailing for?
Oh, you see this? This NOL long-term service, I was with them for a good 35 years. And among 35 years, I was something like 28 years at sea.
Then out of these 28 years, what is the most memorable experience you have while sailing?
The most memorable and the most frightening, I would say, was a time, I really was trying to evade a typhoon, And unfortunately, you know, the typhoon got back at me. You know, it just changed the track and I was going right into the typhoon. And there was like a force 11. Oh gosh, it's really stormy. I think that was the most memorable because I was afraid, but at the same time, I was so brave to stand on to the storm.
The sea is a very dangerous place.
Yep, absolutely.
Okay, so what are the top three countries that you enjoy sailing to, actually?
To start off, you know, everybody loves America, right? Yes, because America is really a place where people want to go and it's so diversified. And, you know, when you're there, it's just like everybody's an American and yet there are people of all colors, you know. And the vibes there are so, so open, so democratic, you know, you just feel so like yourself. And of course, the next place I think is one that is just nearby in our region, that's Thailand, you know. The land of smiles, I mean, I love Thailand. It's a place with good food and with wonderful people. And last but not least, I think South America. I think that's also another place if you talk about Mardi Gras and all that. So that's another place where it's real fun and laughter.
That's nice. Oh, look at those medals there. You see that you have a lot of medals. Where do you get all these medals from?
Mm-hmm. This is another part of my life. Yeah. In fact, this is just the few that I brought from home. I've got something like maybe times five. Of these at home, and these are my running medals. So I've been running for many years in all the running events. In fact, I miss them during this COVID-19. All those physical running is not there. I really miss them, but I still do the virtual run. Well, these are all my running medals, between 5 to 10 kilometers. You know, at my age, I wouldn't be running marathon.
Which one is your favorite, actually?
Favorite? Well, just like what all of us must be. And this is the YOLO run, which basically means you only live once. So enjoy yourself, whatever you're doing. No matter study or play, you should enjoy it.
So, just the last few questions.
Sure. Go ahead. I see you're quite interested in this.
There's quite a few pictures of your students here.
Yeah.
And that one in particular.
Okay. This basically, if you may ask me, is my student corner. And whenever the students give me very inspiring thank you note, you know, these are a few of those students who say a big thank you and words of appreciation. So what I do, I just put them up here and, you know, to keep me going and keep me motivated. And mind you, these are the ones that inspires me to keep on, you know, do what I need to do in NTU. And of course, this particular one is a great testimony to show that, you know, I'm always with you people. When my students excel and my students graduate, it's all smiles and all happiness. So I join in the fun and laughter and enjoy the success of everyone out there.
Yeah, this must be the most like memorable part of your teaching career, right?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, one last question, Captain. Do you have any favorite quote that you live by?
If there's any quote I would like to share with everybody, and has been my quote since small boy up to through your age up to now: play hard, work hard. That's the only two. So, you know, work, play, balance, as in also study, play. I think if you work hard, you need to play hard. If you play hard, you need to work hard.
That's so true. Okay, thank you, Captain. I'll see you around.
Yeah, sure thing. You take good care then.
Thank you.
If you pop in anytime and you guys are free.
Where we walk together hand in hand towards a future so bright. I want the whole world to know. I want to shout it out loud. Yeah, this is where I know I belong.